Hey everyone, welcome back to Amuthu Craft, where we turn metal and mechanics into mesmerizing creations. Today, I have an exciting build for you, a pendulum wave. This simple yet fascinating experiment demonstrates the beauty of physics in motion. Stay tuned until the end to see how I overcame multiple challenges to make it work. If you've seen my previous creation, Newton's Cradle, you'll remember the steel balls I used. For this build, I'm repurposing those same steel balls. First, I cleaned them thoroughly to ensure smooth movement. The key to a successful pendulum wave lies in the thread's lengths. Each thread needs to be a different length. None should be the same, because their variations create the wave effect. I carefully measured and cut the threads, making sure each one was slightly longer than the previous one. To hold the steel balls in place, I built a sturdy metal frame. A horizontal bar was added to suspend the balls. Each ball was carefully attached to the frame at its designated position, allowing them to swing freely. Now for the fun part, testing it out. To start them in sync, I used a bar to push all the balls to the same angle and then released them simultaneously. The result? Well, it worked, but not quite as I expected. I noticed that the swings weren't smooth, and the wave effect wasn't forming correctly. What went wrong? I realized that the threads were too short to allow proper swinging. To fix this, I needed to increase their length. But that meant raising the entire structure. My quick solution? I placed 4 paint cans underneath the frame to lift it higher. Now, I removed all the balls and attached them again with longer threads. This time, I was more precise. I measured the height carefully and marked equal points on the top bar to ensure perfect alignment. Time for another test. As I released the balls, I saw some improvement, but still, it wasn't perfect. I think the gap between balls are too high. So, I am doing it again. This time, the angle of the balls are less. Time for another test. As I released the balls, I saw some improvement, but still, it wasn't perfect. The problem? The balls were colliding with each other, disturbing the movement. Why was this happening? I realized that since each ball was suspended by a single thread, they could sway in different directions instead of moving in a controlled plane. To solve this, I replaced the single thread suspension with 2 threads per ball, forming a V-shape. This restricted sideways movement, ensuring that each ball followed a more precise path. Finally, I set everything up again and tested it one more time. Wow! Now, the movement was much smoother, and the wave effect was clearly visible. It still wasn't perfect, but it was a huge improvement. The process taught me a lot about patience, problem solving, and the beauty of physics in action. I had a great time building this, but there's always room for improvement. Do you have any ideas on how to make it even better? Let me know in the comments. I'd love to hear your thoughts. If you enjoyed this project, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to Amuthu Craft for more creative experiments and artistic metalwork. See you in the next build.